It's the Family Circle Cup right here on the one and only Fox Sports.
Welcome to the 27th Annual Family Circle Cup. We're pleased to share with you once again the beauty of Hilton Head, South Carolina. We're at the Sea Pines Rocket Club host site for the Family Circle Cup. A sellout crowd of more than 8,000 on hand here today under sunny skies for the championship match. Martina Hingis, ranked number one in the world, against the seven seed here, Anna Kournikova. Hi, everyone. I'm Tim Ryan with two-time U.S. Open champion, two-time winner of this event here at the Family Circle Cup. An outstanding match, one that I think all tennis fans, women's tennis, would want to see here today. The number one ranked player in Martina Hingis against Anna Kournikova, rising star looking for her first title.
That's right. She's the unknown quantity out here today, especially because of the situation. Only in her second final of her career, she can be very dangerous. She can beat anybody on the tour on a given day because the ground strokes are so hard and so flat, and she can hit a lot of winners. But then any other day, she can lose to a lot of people because she sprays the ball all over the court and makes too many unforced errors. We'll have to see how this situation affects her.
A pair of teenagers, Kournikova 17, Hingis just 18, but she has been more mature right from the get-go coming out on the tour. And, of course, she has two tournament victories already this season. She has looked very consistent through this tournament. A little erratic on her service in yesterday's semifinal, but otherwise solid.
You always know what you're going to get with Martina Hingis. She's very mentally tough, able to raise the level of her game at crucial situations. If she's not having a good day, if she's spraying balls, then she can change her strategy and go to another game. So I always put my money on Martina Hingis in the finals.
Hingis and Kournikova. And for more on this match, let's go to the third member of our broadcast team down at courtside, Pam Oliver.
Well, thanks, Tim. Distraction, what distraction? Anna Kournikova split from her coach after Lipton, came to Hilton Head, and hasn't missed a beat. After earning a trip to the final, the second of her career, Kournikova quipped in her post-match news conference, "Coach, who needs a coach?" She told us what she has to do versus Hingis and why she's done so well in her debut at this tournament.
I think that I improved with every set I played, and I was really patient. That would really help me in this match today and also against Barbara Schett. So I'm learning to be patient. Well, like you said, she's, you know, the best player in the world, and I really have to play some of the great tennis to win, and I'll just try to show my best tennis and play and work really hard and be patient.
Meanwhile, the jovial Hingis, who has lots of reasons to smile, is seeking her 23rd career title and her second Family Circle Cup in three appearances. Tracy and Tim, back to you, and happy Easter.
Happy Easter to you, Pam, and all of our audience. Coming up, the championship match, number one, Martina Hingis against the seven seed Anna Kournikova, when we return. Hilton Head Island in South Carolina, ready for the championship match of the Family Circle Cup. Martina Hingis, top-ranked in the world, number one seed here, just 18 years old, already with 21 titles. She's won the Australian Open this year, and also the Pan Pacific Open, going for her third championship of 1999.
Let's take a look at her scouting report. Awesome backhand, one of the best backhands in the game. Can hit it hard down the line, also a little soft cross court if she needs to. Very intelligent, can change her game plan if she needs to. Many choices, abundant shot selection. She can hit the soft drop shot, also add the power, can come to the net, and great anticipation.
Anna Kournikova, just 17 years old, from Moscow, and now lives in Miami, Florida, going for her first tournament victory in this final today. She's only been in two finals, once before was last year at the Lipton. Although she has won more than $1 million, she is looking now for a tournament victory to prove that she belongs in the very top rank of the many outstanding young stars.
Let's take a look at Anna's scouting report. Dangerous backhand, hits it very flat and very hard. Incredible mover. Can move well on the clay, runs down everything, all the drop shots, and good volley. Very comfortable moving around the net and does a lot with the volley. Can hit it deep or the drop volley.
These players have met six times before. Hingis leads it 5-1 in the last outing. Kournikova's only win at the German Open in 1998, 6-3, 7-6, 7-1 in the tiebreak. In the last outing at Filderstadt, the victory was to Hingis. And Hingis also has won two out of three they've played on clay. It is 81 degrees here in Hilton Head, South Carolina. Kind of overcast skies, muggy today. Forecast is mostly sunny, and that sun has been coming out in the mid-afternoon, so it should be along any time now. First clay court tournament of the season. It's been an excellent week for the many young stars on the tour. And Anna Kournikova getting her chance to go for victory number one on the WTA Tour here today if she can defeat the top seed Martina Hingis.
There's his mother, Alla. She has now stepped in as her coach as well. Anna had worked with Pavel Klosel for about a year and a half, but released him last week at Lipton.
Hingis to serve. Top of your screen.
Picks the ball off out of the air, and she does that so beautifully. She gets her opponent out of position. She's very comfortable at the net.
Kournikova had a three-setter against Patty Schnieder in the semifinals. Kind of an odd match, a tiebreak first set, and then she won the second set 6-love and had a battle in the third, having lost the tiebreak set.
Quite a long match, an hour and 50 minutes. It was humid yesterday.
Like the 30-all, Hingis for her part defeated the number three seed, Yana Novotna, in straight sets.
Well-placed first serve from Hingis, right in the corner box. 86 miles per hour. She serves usually in the 80s, low 90s.
And an ace for the game, opening game to Martina Hingis. We're underway in this best of three set championship match for the Family Circle Cup. Oliver here at Hilton Head, Martina Hingis's road to the final, a bye in the first round, and then a victory over Sylvia Plischke, followed by the number 10 seed Conchita Martinez, and then the 11th seed Natasha Zvereva, and as we mentioned, the semifinal victory 6-2, 6-3 over Yana Novotna. Anna Kournikova serving at love one here, opening set. Hingis finding an opening. Deep ball for love 15.
Because Martina Hingis has such a great backhand down the line, you're not able to hang out over to that backhand side. You always have to be prepared for that shot up the line, and she also has a great cross court, so really widens the court for herself.
Service return long, 15-30. Right on the line for Kournikova. Pulling Hingis wide, 30-all.
The baseline, and this is what is so impressive about Martina Hingis. When she sees her opponent in trouble, she moves on in towards the net and finishes the point off.
Break point for Hingis. She converted 7 of 16 against Yana Novotna in her semifinal match. She sets. Kournikova comes in and knocks that off. Back to Duke.
Talk about depth. Kournikova's backhand down the line skidded off the line. she hits the ball really flat and hits it very hard as well. She gets a tremendous amount of racket head speed.
Hingis well inside the baseline for the second serve from Kournikova. Long. And it's Kournikova trying to get even at one here in the first set.
Hingis really trying to get used to this different pace than she played yesterday against Yana Novotna, who hit so many slices, mixed up the rhythm. See that both players are going to use the drop shot today, both very good at it. Kournikova, especially in that end of that first set yesterday, hit some great ones to get herself to the tiebreaker. Oh, wild forehand.
A little eager there on that short ball. Came in and jumped on it.
That's the side that does become more wild. The backhand much better technically. The elbow on that forehand gets a little bit too far away from the body.
Second break point is saved by Kournikova. Back to deuce.
So wonderful to see such a variety from both players so early in their careers. They can hit the hard shots, they can hit the short angles with top spins. Don't mind coming up to the net. Great drop shot.
Talked about so early in their career, these are the two youngest players ever to play in a Family Circle Cup final. Hingis at age 18, Anna at 17.
Just about perfect. Look at this quick step. She is very quick. Slides into that backhand. Grew up on the red clay courts in Russia. Also was at Mick Volitari for about 7 or 8 years down in Florida. Came over when she was 9.
Kournikova at 15. You talked about the two youngest players ever to play in the final. It's just a sign of the times, Tracy.
Really is. All have so much potential. Obviously, Martina Hingis, number one in the world already, but I think there is a couple things that she could still improve on, particularly that second serve, sometimes too soft and lands too short in the court. Her mom, Melanie Molitor, looks on. Mom is also the coach.
Game 3, first set.
Look at the other women that were in that group, Venus and Serena Williams. They've really played some great tennis at the beginning of this year, and I think they've only touched on their potential. Amelie Mauresmo, who got to the finals of the Australian Open earlier this year. Extremely talented French woman.
Yeah, she's going to win some tournaments. Great pass from Hingis, 2-1. First set. Well, we turn to the Family Circle Cup after this from your local Fox station. At a talent show for some of the players, got up there with Regis Philbin, dragged him onto stage. He was the MC. Patricia Tarabini from Argentina was the star. Charlton Eagle, that was his Elvis impression, one of the coaches on the tour. A lot of fun, one of the many events the players get to enjoy when they come to play the Family Circle Cup. And there is the MC that night, Regis Philbin, great tennis fan, watching this championship match.
Regis did a great job being the MC. I'm not sure that he was that excited with what he saw, but he handled it beautifully.
I'm not sure he's going to book any of that talent on his show, let's put it that way. Kids had a lot of fun. 30 love. Kournikova on serve here, 1-2 in the first set. Talked about the talented teenagers. Of course, Tracy Austin, the youngest to ever win this tournament at 16 years and 4 months.
Just wide.
Tracy, the difference now, of course, is that there are so many good teenagers all coming out together. You were a bit of a phenom, to say the least, and you had to beat older women. You didn't have that same competition from your own age group.
This is true. Andrea Yeager came up just a couple of years later after me, and Pam Shriver as well.
I have a batch of them here, teenagers now.
When they run up to get the drop shot, first of all, they don't think about hitting the lob over their opponent's head. Number two, they don't have the capability of doing it.
Finishing it off with a pair of overheads, one for the clean winner. 40-15, and game to Kournikova, holding two all, first set.
Road to the final for Kournikova, got a bye, being a seed. Sanchez Lorenzo, tough first set, but came back in the third, 6-1. Andrea Glass retired in that second set with a hip flexor pull, and Patty Schnieder. Kournikova lost the first set 6-7 yesterday and then came back strong, 11-3. Patty Schnieder just really went away in that second set. That is to give Kournikova a tussle in the third.
Wide. Hingis with a little tougher route. She had to beat the number 10 seed Martinez, number 11 Zvereva, and then the number 3 Novotna. Kournikova only a 2 seed. Barbara Chet, number 12, and Schnieder, number 6. Love Hingis.
That win over Shet this week was big for Kournikova because she just lost to her last week at the Lipton, 6-1 in the third. She had lost the week before in the first round to Sylvia Farina at Indian Wells, so didn't come in here with a lot of confidence. And also got rid of her coach last week. There's a lot going on here for Kournikova and has handled it well.
And has been in the doubles draw all week. Hingis choosing not to play doubles here.
Hingis usually plays with Novotna, but has played a couple of doubles tournaments this year with Kournikova, won both.
40-15.
Played at the Australian Open earlier this year together because usually Novotna chooses to miss that tournament. Ended up she was a late entrant and played, but these two had already decided to play.
Yeah. Too good down the line from Hingis, and she holds. We're on serve. No breaks of serve so far. 3-2. Hingis.
Look at the amount of time these players have spent on the court. Number of matches played. Hingis only playing singles. Kournikova singles and doubles. Played with Amanda Kutzer. They lost in the quarterfinals to Davenport and Zvereva. Total time, 5 hours, 25 minutes for Hingis. Over 9 hours for Kournikova. I really think it's the time spent on the singles court that makes the difference, because in doubles, only covering half the court, not that tough on the body.
There's only about 20 minutes differential in their singles play, but Kournikova has been out there playing. She played one late night match in doubles as well.
Yesterday, as I mentioned before, it was a long match, and by the end, she still looked pretty strong. She's very fit, does a lot of fitness exercises off the court. Not that big, not that muscular, very slight, about 5'9", but she gets a lot of power from the racket head speed. Good shoulder turn on that backhand as well, and gets those hips into the shot.
30-15. Barbara Schett and Patty Schneider will be in the doubles final against Elena Likovtseva and Yana Novotna. That title still to be settled here at the Family Circle Cup.
I'm sure that was something in Russian, something I didn't understand. Now, if the umpire understood it, she could give her a warning.
Well, assuming it was something she shouldn't say in public, in any language. Kournikova holds, and so we remain on serve at 3-all. You may have noticed the players between games on the changeover games have quite a luxurious couch to sit on. The green couch is the corporate icon identifying G&J USA Publishing, and Kournikova actually at the end of her three-setter in the semifinals just flopped right onto it like she was in her own living room at home. Company that publishes the magazines, of course, including Family Circle and McCall's parents and several others. That's the corporate icon, Green Couch.
That right there is the beauty of Kournikova's game. She plays a very aggressive style, going for her shots. And when she's on, she is so tough because it's so deep and hard. And when she's wild like off that forehand, then she can lose to anybody. Has bad losses. That forehand definitely more risky, sometimes hits it late. People know that that's the side that can break down. As well as for Hingis. Hingis' backhand much better than the forehand.
In to knock that off easily. 40-15. Thought it was significant in Pam's chat with Kournikova that she mentioned twice in a short span of time. Patience, learning patience, and felt that yesterday's semifinal helped her in that respect. I think Hingis has kind of had that right from the beginning, and I guess that's just a matter of maturing, not just in tennis, but in life.
And also it's just a matter of temperament, the way that you react to things. Kournikova's had to wait for the right shot to go for it. See, that's just too deep. I mean, Hingis really has just not been able to handle that power and that pace today.
I think your point about what a different game than the match against Novotna, lots of slice and drops.
I can't believe she hit it that well. That was not easy. It's a bit of a breeze up there today, so that ball's moving around, and the lob was really high.
Out, close but out. Kournikova wants to reassure Hingis that it was circling the mark in the clay. And a break opportunity for Kournikova, her first.
Wow.
And she gets it. Well advised shot from Hingis, and Kournikova has a break here in the first set.
Last shot from Martina Hingis. She serves a serve, and the next shot in the point, she already tries for a back for a drop shot. Not smart, and she was behind the baseline. Very impatient shot, uncharacteristic of her. She knows you've got to be patient on play. Wait for it.
Kournikova with the break of 4-3 in the first set. That's the three championship final.
I must say, though, I think that Martina Hingis is the one with all the pressure today. She's the number one player in the world, has a lot more to defend. People expect her to win. Kournikova really has nothing to lose.
Hingis, 21-4 in matches in 1999. She won the Australian, she won the Pan Pacific, made the semis at Lipton, lost to Serena Williams, the match preceding the tournament preceding Hilton Head here. Of course, the switch from hard to clay courts. Here at the Family Circle Cup, first of the clay court tournaments for the season. Love 30-second serve.
Two double faults in a row, and that's not something that she wants to start happening. She served five in her match yesterday, but she really had a string of them last fall and early this year.
Triple breaker for Hingis right after being broken. And she's got the break right back. We're on serve again. Today on Fox, Chris Chelios and the new look Red Wings of Detroit face off against Brett Hull and the Dallas Stars as the quest for the Stanley Cup begins to heat up, plus other regional action. It all starts at 3 Eastern, 12 Pacific, only on Fox. Check your local listings for the game in your area right here on Fox. Hingis serving at 4-all.
Anna Kournikova, really, really close friend. Sergei Fedorov plays with the Detroit Red Wings.
You keeping up with that romance? You tell me that they were seen recently during the hockey season in, where was it?
In Palm Springs.
Uh-huh. Good stuff from Daisy Austin. She's all over it here.
Kournikova reading that perfectly. Great anticipation. Had plenty of time. Good stab on that volley. And then look, she even has time to get set, get on balance, whip it down the line. See if Kournikova jumps all over this second serve.
Long three break point for Kournikova.
Wonderful forehand up the line, allowed for that extra 6 inches. Net 6 inches higher there.
Wide, one save by Hingis. Deep slugging by both players on that point. 15-40.
Hingis is going to feel a lot of pressure now to get those first serves in. Kournikova can do so much with the second.
Loose down the line off the forehand side. Two break point save.
Last serve, very smart from Hingis, spun it up high to Kournikova's backhand.
That long, back to Deuce Hingis.
And another one, the third one in a row to that backhand side. She's constantly thinking out there. There's Mom, who's the coach. You got to give her credit, but I think most of it's instinctive.
And so Hingis holds on with three break points against her. She pulls out of it, leads 5-4 in the first.
Most of them to the forehand. That's what you're going to see because she comes outside the right side of the ball when she hits that serve. And the players know that. Not any to the backhand. And you could say, hey, Hingis' backhand is better, but whoever Kournikova plays, most of the time it's to the forehand.
Kournikova serving at 4-5, first set. About 15.
That's definitely something that Kournikova can add to her game, more variety on the serve. Want to keep your opponent guessing. Good mixture.
Eight unforced errors on her backhand now. 16 overall to 9 by Hingis at this stage of the match. Love 30 long from Kournikova. Note that Martina has abandoned her hat that she started the match with. Sky is still overcast, but a little brighter than they were earlier. Very warm in the 80s. Drop shot from Kournikova.
She hits the drop volley so well, and that means that you have good hands, soft hands. Not only can hit that forehand hard, but also uses a drop volley just to cup underneath the ball, take all the pace off of it.
Yes. Another good opportunity to come in on that deep shot. Pays off, 30 all. The match so far.
I'm going to go so far as to say I think she has the best drop shot in the game now, especially because she can do it off the backhand side or the forehand side. Disguises it so well because she waits so long before she goes for the drop shot.
She had Hingis pinned deep to the baseline with those long driving groundies. And there's Hingis back with hers. And that's too good.
She's always up to the challenge. You can do it, I'm going to do it too. Watch that she moves in off the baseline, so she hits it earlier, and Kournikova has less time to react to it. Kournikova trying for the serve down to the backhand side, not successful.
Kournikova is 2-for-4 in the drop shot department, and Hingis 1-for-3. Keep that batting average for
crucial,
you today.
Crucial double fault sets up a set point for Martina Hingis.
That's her third double fault of this first set. Hingis with a set point. And she's got it. Hingis break for the set. 6-4.
Let's look at their records for 1998 on clay. Martina Hingis, number one. And Anna Kournikova, number 8. people very successfully. You look at all those players and they say so comfortable, so patient on the clay courts. That's what you need to do. Points are going to take a little longer to develop and a little longer to finish.
15 love, Hingis, opening the second set. Oh, big forehand from Kournikova.
Good backhand that sets up the forehand as well.
That's long. 30-15, Hingis.
Kournikova has more of a problem when the forehands are down low. Doesn't quite get that racket head down enough and get enough top spin to bring it back down in the court.
Hingis picking up the tempo here, starting the second set. She's serving. And Martina Hingis ripped a forehand pass for a one love lead in the second set. She's up a set. Beautiful Sea Pines racket club, and first set summary of the statistics shows Hingis serving very well at 78%. Kournikova even better at 80%. But look at the numbers and unforced errors, key in that first set, along with the double fault.
Double fault's really key from Kournikova because she was serving at 4-3 up a break, and she served the first 2 points a double fault, so got down love 30 in that game and lost her serve at love, gave the break back. And then the other double fault was when she was serving down 4-5, 30-all, she served another double fault. Double faults have been too big, too large in her life the last 6 months. The second round match against Miho Saki. She had 31 double faults in the match, and remember, you only need 24 points to win a set. Came back, still won that match.
Another double fault there. Ball love 30 here in the second game of the second set.
This drop shot right here opens up the court down the line. Kournikova fills it.
Hingis smiled all the way back. Kournikova a little more all business at this point. Ran a mile on that point and wound up with a winner. Somewhat risky, actually.
This one had a little bit of spin. Hingis took her time, went for the angle. She does show her emotions out there, whether she wins the point or not. It'd either be a big smile or crack a racket.
Kournikova has been moving again. Still with a break point. Martina Hingis Up one love here in the second set. And Hingis breaks through for a two-love lead here in the second. Well, tonight on Fox Sunday, it's a Sunday of epic proportion. First visit the Garden of Eden, Simpsons style, on an all-new episode. And then from the creator of The Simpsons comes the hit comedy a thousand years ahead of its time, Futurama. Fox's epic Sunday starts tonight at 7 Central, 8 Eastern time.
Her make her way on the WTA Tour last year with a few breakthroughs at the Lipton. She was that a year ago, got to the finals, lost to Venus Williams. Oof. With shots like that, she can be so dangerous. In fact, in that tournament, she beat four top 10 players. Celis, Davenport, Martinez, and Sanchez Vicario. Lost in three sets to Venus Williams. Six top 10 players in 1998. One of her big wins was beating Steffi Graf at Eastbourne, which was the warm-up tournament to Wimbledon in June.
Oh, great anticipation again from Hingis, 30-15.
Excuse me, just hits it so early. So confident on that backhand side.
Hingis with a set in hand. Up a break here in the second. Going for her third tournament championship. They won the Australian Open and the Pan Pacific. 40-15. And Kournikova looking for her first title on the tour. You know that she's going to have some with all of that talent. It's a question of when the breakthrough will come. She'd like it to be here today. She'll need a comeback against the top ranked player in the world.
When she beat Steffi Graf at Eastbourne last June, she fell during that match and tore some ligaments in her right hand and was out for most of the summer. So that really ruined the second half of her 1998. That's when she started having problems when she came back in October with the serve. Lots of double faults.
Just long. Backhand's been letting Kournikova down. 10 unforced errors now from that side, and she trails 3-love down a set. Family Circle magazine and Hormel Foods created an award that honors a woman tennis player made contributions of both time and energy to worthy causes. This year's winner, Monica Seles, has made a difference through the Make-A-Wish Foundation, the Special Olympics, and the American Cancer Society. Very generous with her time and her own money. She's just a great supporter of worthy causes. Monica Seles. Monica was in the tournament here, knocked out earlier in the competition.
She lost to Elena Lakotova, 6-2. Lost a couple of weeks ago at Indian Wells to Nagyova, and last week at the Lipton to Serena Williams, so not a great 3 weeks for Monica.
Backhand angle from Kournikova, 30 love. Trying to get on the board here in the second set at love three.
She has a big heart. She is a great fighter. I think actually has won a couple of her matches this week just on sheer will and determination.
Well, she's come back from being a set down to win. Defeated Sanchez Lorenzo and then Patty Schneider in the semifinal.
I really think that she wants to win so badly to make people feel like she warrants all this attention that she gets. Oh. Kournikova with a great reply on the drop shot. Smart, just dump it back over the net. Make them come on in and hit the ball up. Ball just tends to die on the play.
40-15. Try to get down the backhand side. Just a little dink return of serve. Fooled Kournikova.
I talked about the versatility of shots. This is it right here. It's pretty far in the court, pretty deep. Not an easy shot to hit and hit the clean winner.
Kournikova holds and she's on the board here in the second set. Down 3-1. Well, today on Fox, Chris Chelios and the new-look Detroit Red Wings will meet Brett Hull and the Stars as the quest for the Stanley Cup begins to heat up, plus other regional action. All starting at 3 Eastern, 12 Pacific, only on Fox. Check your local listings for the game in your area right here on Fox NHL Hockey Action. Hingis, love 15. Good game here for Kournikova. And she's got a love 30.
Hingis did this against Natasha Zvereva in the quarters. Hingis won the first set there, 6-love, and was up 3-1. Let Zvereva back in the match.
And three break points for Kournikova.
Had to finish that second set against Zvereva 7-6. Kind of a wild game here for Hingis.
Still trailing considerably in the unforced errors department. Kournikova with 24, Hingis now with 12. No error there.
I think even when both of these players are playing their best tennis, that Kournikova is going to have more unforced errors and usually more winners because that's just her style of play. More aggressive.
One break point saved by Hingis. Comes in on that high looper and saves another one.
13, 14. Just reads it so well. Just before Kournikova hits this shot, she started to move in a couple of feet off that baseline. Cranks it up.
Oh. Kournikova steps inside the baseline here for the second serve. Another backhand error. She's been troubled with that today. Deuce.
Really a key game here for Kournikova to get herself back into this match. Doesn't want to get down 4-1 in the second set. Wow, great backhand. Especially after being up 40-love in this game, you can't let that slip through your fingers.
Fourth break point. Fans are here using the little fans that have been handed out by one of the sponsors. Foxy Lady, of course, she's used to that glamour girl stuff, and she made a good point this week when it was raised, as it always is at a press conference, how do you feel about being the sex symbol of the tour and all that stuff? And she said, hey, we have a WTA magazine out. I'm not the only woman in it. There are 12 other female players in the magazine, and I don't want to be just a sex symbol. I want to known and recognized as one of the top players. Well, that's her effort here. She's in a final trying to win her first championship.
Does want that recognition for being successful on the court, but it's just so tough to forget the beauty of it because every time she practices, there's just men hanging on the fence. And she really has that star quality. It goes way past her tennis. Everywhere she goes, she just has people following her.
difficult shot that she nearly converted. 15 all. On serve at 1-3.
Watch her read this so well. Already starts scooting over towards that backhand side. Hingis likes to hit that high one inside out.
What a good return.
But again, Kournikova going to that forehand side way too many times. Hingis just waiting there.
Just 67 miles an hour left in her hitting range. Two great points for Hingis.
Martina Hingis is just so tough because where do you hit to her? Her backhand is very tough. Her forehand is improved immensely. More powerful, less unforced errors.
One break point save. All being questioned by Hingis. And out of the chair comes Leanne White, the chair umpire from Essendon, Australia, to take a peek. And of course, she says it's long. And
that's foul wide. Seriously. It's going to reach there and it's picked up like that, but seriously, it's that foul wide. Yeah, but did you hear it? Well, maybe hit that reach. I don't know, but it's definitely wide. Like, we'll leave him out there to look at it
tonight. Confirmed decision by Leanne White.
Hingis is complaining. Obviously, she's far away, but she feels that it's the sound that she heard of the ball hitting the tape.
Tape. And Hingis comes through with a break. Her second of the set and a 4-1 lead. 4-2 lead, pardon me.
86 weeks at the number one, as the number one ranked player. 5 Grand Slam titles. Won the Australian Open earlier this year in January. Won 3 Grand Slam titles in 1997. The Australian Open, Wimbledon, and the U.S. Open. Only missed winning the French Open, where she lost in the finals to Mioli. Last year won the Australian, and this year as well. 15.
Kournikova spraying the forehand, 15 all. That was a fine drop shot from deep in the court from Kournikova.
That takes such great feel and such great finesse because she gets it over that net about 3 inches, judges it perfectly.
Right on the line. Right back the other way. Hingis prevails. Kournikova thought that her looping shot was long.
Incredible. 2 looping shots right on the baseline, both sides. Both showing a tremendous amount of versatility. Have all the shots in the book at such a young age.
Pretty all. Point Kournikova. 2 of 8 on break points in this match so far. Huge one here.
Most of the time when you see the young champions come up, they have more of a one-dimensional game and start to add to it.
Too good from Hingis.
First time I saw both of these young girls play, they were 13 years old and they were playing in Junior Wimbledon. There was a huge crowd around, and I tell you, the players' tea room, the balcony, was full. Everybody had heard so much about them. They already had all-court games.
Drop shot from Kournikova from the backhand side this time, and another great point.
Not only does she cut this drop shot so close to the net, but she hits it with so much backspin that once you get there, the ball is moving away from you. I'm surprised that Hingis even got there.
Second break point of this game.
From Hingis, only 67 miles per hour, but up deep and high to the Kournikova backhand. Can't do much with it. Way over her head. Opens up the court with the cross court. Hingis hits the winner down the line.
Oh, she made a great forehand return and then did not handle the next one. Vanish Hingis.
Covered the top of the ball too much. On the second forehand, hit down too much.
Deep to the corner from Hingis, who holds the 5-2. She's up a set. Molitor on the left, Molitor, who is the mother of Hingis, of course. And you know what they're going through. Both coaches now, by circumstance.
Melanie Molitor was a top-ranked player in Czechoslovakia. She's now, of course, the Czech Republic and Slovakia. Named her daughter after Martina Navratilova.
Kournikova serving to stay in this match at 2-5.
Kournikova with very solid volleys and great technique. Gets down well for that. Look how she moves in forward, attacks that volley. Nice and firm.
Perfect drop shot from Hingis.
Hell of a drop shots out here. Both hit them very, very well. Hingis, the first one hard, the second one soft. Great feel. I actually saw these two win the doubles title at Indian Wells, and it was so much fun to watch because it wasn't like they were playing singles on a doubles court. They knew exactly where to move together. Volley, both extremely comfortable at the net.
Certainly would be formidable as a constant doubles pair, and who knows, you may see that happen in their careers. Their net points today reflect their abilities there. Hingis has won 12 of 18, Kournikova 11 of 15. Long from Hingis, 40-30.
Kournikova certainly not trying to slow things down in between the points. You're allowed 20 seconds, but she's playing very quickly.
Quick backhand, 5-3, Martina Hingis will now serve for the match. Kournikova has one break in this second set. She broke Hingis once in the first set, which Hingis won 6-4. She must break here to extend this.
Martina Hingis has talked about how she's tired a little bit physically as well as mentally, playing three big tournaments in a row, but she has a month break after this. I tell you, she looks sharp today. Very solid tennis and very aggressive. She stepped in and hit the ball extremely early on the rise.
And even though you have said frequently that she needs to still work on her second serve, she's done well there today, 11 to 15 points on it so far. 12 of 16 on the last one. There's a pass from Hingis to 40 love, three match point for Martina Hingis. Sun shining now on these two bright stars in tennis here at beautiful Hilton Head, South Carolina. Hingis going for her second Family Circle Cup championship. She won it in 97. There it is. Hingis prevails in a love game against Anna Kournikova in just her second tour final. It is the third tournament victory of the year for Martina Hingis. She won the Australian Open Grand Slam tournament, then the Pan Pacific, and now the Family Circle Cup, the first of the clay court tournaments that lead to the French Open in Paris in late May. 6-4, 6-3 for the top seed and number one ranked player in the world, Martina Hingis over Anna Kournikova. We'll have more from Hilton Head in a moment. Martina Hingis has defeated Anna Kournikova 6-4 and 6-3 to win the Family Circle Cup. Let's join the winner with our Pam Oliver.
Okay, thanks a lot, Tim. Martina, congratulations on winning your second Family Circle Cup. It must feel very good.
Oh, it does. I mean, I always had kind of very successful tournament here. That's where I became number one at this tournament, and I really feel very happy today.
What was the difference in the match? Do you feel like she really gave you a good competition?
Well, I mean, it was a great result for her to come into the finals here. And, you know, she had a tough tournament. The last three tournaments, she always played singles and doubles. We won together, actually, in Indian Wells, and we practiced also many times together. So we probably know each other a little bit, and, well, not only probably, it's for sure. And, you know, she had a few three-setters here, so she definitely was a little bit tired, and I could take advantage of that.
And now you get to take a breath.
Oh, definitely. I'm going to take a break a little bit, like almost a month. I'm not going to play any tournaments before I go back to Europe. I stay here and, you know, enjoy the sun up here. It was pretty hot today, though.
Thanks a lot, and congratulations. It's been a delight working with you. Let's go back upstairs to Tim.
Okay, Pam, congratulations to Martina Hingis. And there's Mom, Melanie Molitor, congratulating her daughter's effort. A solid performance against the number 7 seed, Anna Kournikova. For Anna Kournikova, making her second final on the WTA Tour, losing to number one Martina Hingis. Let's join her now with Pam Oliver.
And we're having a seat on the green couch, too, Tim. Anna, it's not exactly the result that you wanted, but you still must be pretty proud about how you performed in this tournament.
Yes, you know, it was a great tournament for me, and I'm happy with my performance. I was a little bit tired today. I played a lot of tennis, but Martina played well, and, you know, I'm happy that I got to the finals.
So it sort of caught up with you, those 9 hours you spent on the court this week?
Yes, this morning I woke up, I was pretty tired, but, you know, I was just happy to be out here, and I really enjoyed playing.
What's next for you?
I'm playing Amelia Island next week.
Looking forward to that one?
Yes, definitely. It's another tournament, starts tomorrow, so, you know, hopefully I'll just recover and play as well as I did here.
Is this a good confidence builder for you going into Amelia Island?
Well, I think it's great, not just for Amelia Island, for the rest, you know, of the tournaments to come. I think it's really good for me, and it really helped me. I won some tough matches, and, you know, my game is back on track, and I'm feeling great.
Thank you so much. Let's go back up to Tim.
Thanks, Pam. We'll be back here at the Family Circle Cup. We'll be joining Susie Colbert at the Fox Sports Center after this message.
I'm very determined. I'm a fighter. I don't give away points easily. Maybe this is because of my background.
too hot for television until now. An all-new special, Banned in America, the world's sexiest commercials. Wednesday.
For the presentations to the winner, Martina Hingis, and the runner-up, Anna Kournikova. Let's go down to the court and Pam Oliver.
We want to thank you guys for making this a terrific tournament. You're a terrific crowd for the whole week. And can we have Anna Kournikova join us now? She's certainly a crowd favorite. And now I want to take this opportunity to introduce you to Jim McEwen, who is publisher of Family Circle magazine. Jim?
Thank you. Thank you, Pam. This is a very special year for us here at the Family Circle Cup, because between them, Anna Kournikova and Martina Hingis are the two youngest players to ever face each other in the finals. Anna, you played terrific tennis all week. The fans loved it. The people on watching television loved it. And we at Family Circle really enjoyed it. Thanks for being here. And I'd like to give you this check for $70,000 runner-up check. Thank you.
And something tells me she won't be a runner-up for much longer. Anna, let's talk about this match today. What were the difficulties for you out there?
Well, like Martina said, I played a lot of tennis this week, so I felt a little bit tired, but Martina played a great match, and congratulations. I was just happy to be out here today, and I really enjoyed playing. I made a few unforced errors, but, I'll learn, and I'll get some experience, and hopefully, like you said, I won't be losing any much longer.
Is this a nice stepping stone for you, your second final of your career? You were certainly a crowd favorite, and I think a big favorite with the men.
The crowd is certainly favorite of mine. Well, it's great for me. It's good for my confidence, and I'm really happy that my game is back on track. I'm feeling great, playing great. I just have to, recover, and I'll start playing well again.
And Amelia Island up next for you. Very delightful to work with you.
Thank you.
Anna Kournikova, everybody. And up next, we want to introduce you to Susan Ungara, who is the editor-in-chief of Family Circle magazine.
Thank you, Pam.
Martina,
come on out.
Martina, on behalf of Family Circle, I'm delighted to congratulate you on your second Family Circle Cup championship. Two years ago when you won the cup, you were the number one player in the world, and you still are. And it gives me great pleasure to award you the Family Circle Champion Cup. And we hope that you'll be back with us next year on another glorious Sunday. Thank you. There's more, Martina. I'd like to introduce you to Carlene Pruitt, Director of Public Relations for L'Oreal.
Nice. Congratulations on a terrific tournament. And because you are worth it, it is my pleasure to present you with a check on behalf of L'Oreal for $150,000. Congratulations.